Next, we have poster 70, which is titled Factors Associated with the Utilization of the Dengue School Card for the School-Based Dengue Control Program among Grade 9 students in the Horana Educational Zone. The authors are Bandara T.D., Kada M., and Jayavardhana R. The presenting author is Bandara T.D.
Good morning, everybody. Again, thank you to SLMA for the opportunity provided. The title of this poster that I'm presenting is The Factors Associated with the Utilization of the Dengue School Card for the School-Based Dengue Control Program among Grade 9 students in the Horana Educational Zone. The Dengue School Card is a novel dengue control campaign which is introduced by the NDCU, the National Dengue Control Unit, in collaboration with the Education Ministry. And it has been distributed among students in certain districts of the country. And it aims, it is a one-page card which can be used for 6 months. It is supposed to be used once a week at home by the students. The principles of using the card has been taught to the students in school, and they are supposed to go home and during the weekend assess the areas around their house and inside their house and check whether there are breeding places for dengue mosquitoes inside or outside their houses, and to take actions to prevent and control the breeding and mark it. So when marking, there is a visual feedback to the students, and the class teacher or the area PHI is supposed to check whether they have done it properly and whether they have understood it. It is expected that at the beginning there will be lots of places around in and around their homes which can breed dengue mosquitoes, and as the student routinely carries out this activity with routine checking, the amount of breeding places will reduce. That is the plan, and this is a behavioral change intervention that has been introduced. So this also plans to use the school children as behavior change agents to introduce the concept to the parents and to the neighborhood, and thereby to the whole country. That is the aim of the plan. And the objective of the study was to assess the factors associated with the utilization of the dengue school card, which was given to the students. A descriptive cross-sectional study was carried out using cluster sampling, and 782 students were involved in the study. They were given frequent reminders to bring the card for objective assessment, because the objective assessment was necessary to see whether they had actually marked it. We needed the card to see the objective assessment. However, out of the 782, only 341 had brought the card on the day of the assessment for objective assessment. Among those, only 52.5% had a good utilization as objectively assessed. There were many factors which were assessed. And there was a statistically significant association with good utilization with being a student of a type 2 school, which is a school. There are several types of schools in the Education Ministry: type 1 AB, type 1 C, type 2 and type 3. Type 1 AB will have up to A-level classes with science and maths for A-levels, science, maths and arts streams for A-levels. Type 1 C will have A-level classes but with only arts. Type 2 will have up to O-level. Type 3 will be up to primary. So the primary type 3 schools were not involved in the study because we were taking grade 9 students. The type 2 schools, being a student of type 2 schools, increased the chances of the utilization of the dengue school card, and the increase in level of knowledge and the increase in level of reported current practices also increase the utilization of the dengue school card. The gender, religion, ethnicity, education level of parents, employment status of parents, socioeconomic level of parents, previous experience of dengue in self, in a family member, or the death of a known person from dengue, or the attendance of an awareness program were not significantly associated with utilization.
The paper is open for discussion.
So type 2 is the schools that are with classes up to O-levels.
O-levels, madam, yes. They're generally smaller in size than the type 1AB and 1C. So they have a less number of students. And it has also been observed when we conduct competitions or other things among schools that the students in type 2 schools provide a better outcome. As in, like, they're more interested in being involved in it, and they give a better output when you do competitions. So it needs to, like, further evaluation needs to be done, further research has to be done as to why, what the factors in type 2 schools are that we get a better performance in those students.
The I was wondering, now out of the 600 odd numbers that who took part in the study, and only 300
yes,
brought the cards, and out of them also that only 150, so it's only 25% of the
yes,
participants who had responded for
yes. No, madam, it's like this. We took 782 students who participated in the study in the self-administered questionnaire. Of all of them were informed 1 week in advance and on the day before to bring the card on the day of assessment. And then on the day that we went, I personally went to assess it objectively. And they, of those who had brought, only the 52%, that is, if
so,
you take
so
the total
number. Of the people, 52% brought.
Brought.
And
no.
Out of them?
Yeah, out of the total, approximately 50% brought. Of
yes,
them, another 50% performed well.
So it's only 25%
yes,
altogether.
Yes, but we do not have the data on the students who did not bring the card, who actually marked the card
no,
but forgot to bring it.
At the end, it's only 25%
yes,
who responded for the card.
Yes.
So why do we say that it's a good practice? Out of 700...
Mm-hmm.
It's only 25% responded, no?
Yes, madam. We are not saying it's a good practice overall. We are assessing factors that affect the utilization of the card.
Right.
So among the utilization, we have assessed whether they have marked, like whether they have brought the card, whether they have marked the card, whether they have marked it weekly, whether they have done it correctly, whether they
right,
have understood it, and whether they have considered all the factors. When we assess all of that and put it into a weighted questionnaire, then that is the result that we have gotten.
And in your sample, the type 2, the number of students in type 2 schools also seem to be quite few, no, compared to
yes,
the
it we did a cluster sampling method with probability proportionate to population size.
Mm-hmm.
So it was proportionate to the population size. So according to that only, the sample size.
But the sampling size was adequate for the statistical
yes,
analysis? Yes,
because we took the total sample size was 782. So that was adequate for statistical analysis.
And did you look at, like, in the ones who did not bring the cards, did you look at the, distribution of type of schools and things like that?
No, sir. We have the data, but I have not analyzed it that way.
Because that's again another utilization
group
issue, no?
Yes.
Not bringing the card itself is
yes. Most of them had forgotten, sir. And
I
some schools use the method where they would store the card in school and give it out to the student on Friday, and they would bring it back on Monday. In those schools, all of the cards were present. But if the student was given the card to keep, the card was usually the bringing of the card was erratic. Thank you.
Please give a round of applause.